In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of diaphragm. Diaphragm, which is this muscle. This is primary breathing muscle, right? I am going to explain its origin, insertion, function, and important anatomical connection. Let me explain origin first. First part is this part, this bony prominent. This is xiphoid process. Xiphoid process, which is the lowest part of sternum. Okay, next part is this area. Actually, there is costal cartilage like this. Diaphragm originates from costal cartilage and rib cage. So, rib cage plus costal cartilage. Basically, this area. Okay? Now, let's go back to more posterior part. Do you see there is arch right here? This area. There is ligament on this area. This is lateral arcuate ligament. Lateral arcuate ligament. Okay. And there is one more ligament, archi ligament, right here. This is medial arcuate ligament. Medial arcuate ligament. Then there is kind of a elongation from diaphragm. This is crura of diaphragm. Crura. Crura means leg. Its shape is like legs, right? These guys originates from lumbar spines. Most of anatomy books say L1 through 3, or depends on people, maybe some people's diaphragm attaches on L4, or maybe even L5. That depends on people. Anyway, diaphragm originates from lumbar spines. If diaphragm originates from lumbar spines, that also originates from intervertebral disc. Intervertebral disc, about this area, right? So this is very important information. When diaphragm gets tight, maybe that can put stress to discs. What's gonna happen? Maybe that may occur herniated disc, right? I don't say tight diaphragm always makes herniated disc. It's not, but that can be possibility. The chronic tension of diaphragm might cause herniated disc kind of indirectly, right? Does it make sense? That is why this is very, very important for lumbar spines. And one more thing. Do you see yellow tissues on lumbar spines? This is ligament. What kind of ligament is that? That is anterior longitudinal ligament. Anterior longitudinal ligament. This ligament is very long. This is just showing you lumbar spine part, but it goes up through thoracic spines and cervical spines. So if this part gets tight, this tension can follow up all the way up to cervical spines. That is why tightness from diaphragm can affect all spines. Does it make sense? Anyway, these are origins of diaphragm. That's a lot, right? So basically, it is this area, okay, this contour is origin of diaphragm. Now, let me explain its insertion. This is inferior view of diaphragm. Remember, this part is origin. Insertion is this white part, okay? This is tendon. This tendon is called central tendon. Central tendon. This is very unique muscle. Most of muscles insert to bone, but diaphragm inserts to this tendon. Very, very interesting. When this central tendon is lowered down, now we can inhale, we can put air into our lungs. When this central tendon goes up, now we can exhale, right? So this up and down movement of central tendon, of course diaphragm, is important for breathing. So main function of diaphragm is, of course, breathing. This is primary breathing muscle in human body. Other muscles are secondary. These other muscles assist diaphragm. So main guy is this guy. Now for next part, let me explain innervation of diaphragm little quick. Okay, innervation of diaphragm is phrenic nerve. This nerve is from C3 through 5. This is very important when I have to talk about relationship between internal organs and shoulder joint connection or thoracic connection. I will not talk about every single detail about this connection, but when you see other videos that I am talking about relationship between organs and joint, phrenic nerve is key tissue. So please remember this. This is very important thing. Now, I just said there is internal organ around diaphragm. This is liver. This is stomach. Both stomach and liver have kind of a attachment surface with diaphragm. Then if you go to upper side, there is what? Lung above diaphragm. One more tissue. What's there? This yellow one. This is heart. So basically, I focus on these four organs that have attachment surface with diaphragm. So when liver and stomach do not move very well, that can affect movement of diaphragm. When there is adhesion on attachment surface between heart, lungs, and diaphragm, maybe diaphragm cannot move very well. I don't say tight diaphragm makes organ disease like hepatitis or heart attack or heart disease. I am not talking about that. I am talking about anatomical connection between organs and diaphragm. So when diaphragm does not move well, internal organ doesn't move well. Maybe if internal organs do not move well, maybe diaphragm cannot move well. Plus, diaphragm is very important for stability of core. It's important for thorax movement and stability. And it's important for abdominal movement and abdominal stabilization. Okay, this is very important thing. That is why the condition of diaphragm is important. So in this video, I explained basic anatomy of diaphragm. I explained its origin, insertion, function, and important anatomical connection. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.